Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 and our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on our next and might actually be last retaliation strike on Operation Witch Shriek. And today we're gonna bring Jesse, our adept Psy operative, then Jazz with the Storm Gun, Plasma Blast in a war suit and the Mimic Beacon. Of course, Ulrich also with a war suit and the Shred Storm Cannon, EMP bombs, and incendiary bombs, then Yang also with a war suit with the blaster launcher, venom rounds, and the acid bomb, and then I put the raid suit on Vinny, who looks amazing in that suit, and still of course carries the blue screen rounds, and then of course Hugh, since I do want to have that healing in this mission, and he's doubling down in this mission as a skulljacker as well. So here we go. I don't think we ever took this team. It's quite colorful. But yeah, hopefully this works out. 11 enemies, mostly a split between organic and mechanical. Menace, ready to deploy. So we should be able to take them out.
We just got word the aliens are hitting a resistance outpost with everything they've got, and our people don't stand a chance against them. We're heading in to secure the area. Eliminate all enemy contacts.
So as always, eliminate all contacts and rescue at least 6 civilians. In East Asia, apparently, this time. New Earth Ridge. I'm hoping this will pan out okay, because we've never failed a retaliation mission. But that has some pretty bad side effects if you do. Because when you fail these missions, you have a chance at losing that region completely.
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
So we didn't bring a scout.
Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Which isn't that bad, because we need to move as fast as we can anyway. And scouts just hold us back a bit. So I'll see you guys in a second once I've set this up.
Advent troops here!
Oh, there we go. I've put Vinny up top with his grapple hook, but apparently we didn't trigger them yet. Interesting. Maybe I should just do that immediately. I can get a shot at the Berserker, but not at any of the other guys over there. So, Yang, how far does your grenades go? Need to select those. Of course, just to the edge of our sightline, which is obvious, but the blaster bomb is another story. So if I put that over here, trying to not hit any civilians, which I might actually do here by accident. But this should be it, right? Here we go.
Dodge this!
Might be a bit early to use a blaster bomb. But there we go. I don't think I hit anything else. And now they should be coming our way. We shredded the armor of the mech, which should make it an easy kill from here. And of course the civilians start running away. I don't know what that trooper in the back is doing. Something ran away in the back there, which is interesting. So, okay, it's the mech that just ran away, which is not that bad. Might just take a lightning hand shot at the lancer over there. Nope, and that was even a miss. He did lose some cover though. But I'm gonna try and see what I can do with anybody else. Soul fire. Does guaranteed psionic damage to an organic enemy, ignores cover and armor. Okay, then let's put you in a better position to just take out the lancer then. If I put one over here, do we save the civilians? Apparently not. Ah, there we go. Yeah, we do. So let's just take Jesse first and go with soul fire on the lancer. Goodbye, good sir. There we go. Her first psionic attack. Blammo! Goodbye, good sir. Okay. That's that. And now we need to focus all our fire on the berserker over there. Just gonna try and put everybody a bit closer. And hopefully try and keep a few overwatch shots for when the mech returns, because that thing is gonna come back. Unless he just doesn't want to. 91% shotgun shot. That is not bad. Full ammo. Ooh, 13 damage with the critical. And that just leaves one more shot that he needs to get. Which I might actually just take with a pistol shot. There we go, 100% shot. Goodbye, good sir. Berserker. That was a nice camera angle. Just gonna put him on Overwatch. You on Overwatch. Do I boost Ulrich a bit further to take that civilian? I'm not gonna take the chance, because it might be, you know what it might be, a shapeshifter. Okay. There's stuff happening over there. He's just gonna fire at a civilian probably. Oh, and he misses. What was that? That's looked like a mutant. But somebody else is probably gonna try and fire at him. That sounds like a sector bolt. Yeah. Ooh, brutally murdered. Holy hell, I'm sorry I couldn't. Holy hell, yeah. Something like that. Sorry I couldn't save you there. Immune to whatever exploded there. And there he is. There's the mech. Might actually kill him with this shot. There we go. Goodbye. Holy shit. I think he just dropped through the floor. And kind of flipped around a bit. Okay. High time we start moving. Because we do need to save as many civilians as we can. We already saved one, which is good. But we don't need to rest on our laurels after that, of course. So let's boost Jazz further. Let's put Ulrich right next to that civilian over here. There we go, that's our second civilian. And I could put Jazz in a better position there, right next to that civilian. But I'm not going to take the risk just yet. I'm just going to move everybody up and try to get them in a better position than we have right now. There's a little wall over there. Not really that good of a position. I'm just gonna put you behind the tree. And then Ulrich behind the tree over here. And then I think I'm gonna have to go on Overwatch. Unless I keep Jazz's Mimic Beacon handy. Yeah, okay, let's go for it. Let's just move Yang up a bit closer. Yeah, there we go. She spotted something. There we go, a mech and a normal trooper. Should be within the realm of possibility to take out. And otherwise we have the Mimic Beacon. Oh, shit. Okay, for some reason, oh, we can hit the mech from here. That is good, because it's a 100% chance, which is something I'm going to do immediately. Goodbye. So that removes the Overwatch, I think. Did it remove? Oh, hair trigger. Oh, man, I love that thing. Yeah, okay, then you're just dead. You're completely dead. Goodbye, even a critical. Wow. Yeah, I'm very impressed, Vinny. Thank you very much. For that kill, inspire, grant a bonus action immediately to a nearby squad mate. I might actually use that in a minute. Who else has sight on the trooper? So we only have Jazz, who can't use his sword attack to get there, and his attacks are pretty bad at the moment, but he still has the plasma blaster. And since that is very situational, I might as well just use it here, because it destroys all the cover as well. And it might actually kill him. So yeah, plasma blaster. Blammo! Oh, one damage short. Hopefully I didn't kill any civilians in the back there. And then Hugh. Hugh can't see him. So I think I'm gonna go for... Who can I give an action to? I can actually give an action to Jazz or Ulrich as well. Which is interesting. I think Ulrich would get the better shot. Although Hugh might actually get the better shot. So let's inspire Hugh.
We have nothing to fear.
Is that actually... Yeah, she's going to use that thing for that as well. There we go. That is awesome. I never actually used Psy operatives that intensively. So now he has an extra action. Which means I can put him a bit closer. And fire at the trooper over there. Hopefully hitting it. 85, that's not even 100%, so here goes nothing. There we go, thank you. Even a critical 13 damage, kind of overkill, but thank you, Hugh. And then I'm just gonna put, who do we have left? Oh, nobody. Yeah, the Andromedon killed the closest civilian we had. Which is bad, of course. But that does mean we can get a bit closer to draw its attention now that we know where he is. So two civilians down, which still means we only... we can let five civilians die. But we don't really want to have that happen. Of course, as always, the only downside of me using the plasma blaster is that I don't have any good cover right now. Jesse, let's get you behind this tree stump, which is apparently not cover. So let's just go over here behind the rock. Not spotting anything just yet. Then Ulrich.
Gate closed.
Damn it. I'm not getting close enough to spot him. That will probably do it. Yeah, there we go. That'll probably do it. That's two codexes and an Andromedon. Which is, well, bad to say the least. This might be a good moment to start using the Mimic Beacon. I could go for the Codex over here. And just sword slash him. Can I actually fire at it as well? 81% chance to shoot at that Codex over there. I'm just gonna wait, of course, with Jazz, because he has the Mimic Beacon. If I do anything risky, I'm not gonna do it with him. Let's move things up a bit. We have shots at everything, and Vinny can at least kill one of the codexes, which is good. Probably gonna go for that one over there then, since it's 98, and the other ones will not have that good of a shot. I can't use the grappling hook yet, so I can't even get him closer. I could try and use domination on the codex. So permanently mind control an enemy. Only one successful domination can be performed per mission. I can try that, because I don't think I have that good of a shot. No, I don't. So I am going to try and use, even though it's a very low percentage chance, to try and take over the codex. The thing is, I don't have another use for her at the moment. Oh, that actually worked. Oh, that is so cool. That is good. That is very, very good. Do I get that immediately? Or is it the same as the hacking? Yeah, it's the same as the hacking. I can't use that codex immediately. So let's fire at the codex over there. And hopefully killing it in one blow. There we go. 15 damage. Blown to Kingdom Kong. And then we need to draw out the Andromedon. And another hair trigger action, seriously. That means I'm gonna come closer. Because we're starting to lose the usefulness of his position over there. And yeah, just reload, because I don't think Vinny has an autoloader, because he doesn't usually need it. Because you don't really use him like as a sniper usually. 22% on the Andromedon. Which means I'm not gonna use him. 34 on the Andromedon. Can I actually... Oh, that was not what I wanted to do. Can I actually use a acid bomb from here? Because if we can get rid... Yeah, we can. If we can get rid of the armor, that would be nice as well. There we go. Shred everything and a bit of damage. That is a nice start. But of course, we're still going to have to use the Mimic Beacon here. Could put you over there. Probably just not enough for a flank shot. So yeah, oh, Hugh doesn't even see him. I'm actually wondering if I use Jazz's Mimic Beacon right now. So I use his Mimic Beacon and put it... can I just put it... Oh, I can, I saw it. I can bounce it off. No, I'm just gonna put it there in the corner. But then, of course, we still have an ability we can use. If I use 8 protocol to give 40 defense to our Mimic Beacon. Oh, I can't even do that. Oh, that would have been funny. But yeah, then I'm just gonna put him on Overwatch. Oh, there's something else awake over there. Yeah, the sector pod is moving around. Raul Lopez, I'm sorry, man. Sorry, we couldn't we got you killed. We couldn't save you. That's what I wanted to say.
We're losing civilians left and right, Commander. We need to get these people out of here.
Oh yeah, we're gonna get spotted, aren't we? Yeah, there we go. Oh, that was a screenshot of the episode, I think. So sector pod, shield bear, and something else. They're right on the edge of our sideline. And I think it might actually have been the Mimic Beacon that drew the fire. Ooh, Hugh misses, but he gets 2 damage in. He's gonna punch the Mimic Beacon. Which is actually pretty bad, because that means I only have a few ways of dealing with... Oh, shit. With those 3 thingies over there. Because in an ideal world, I would wanna... Oh, come on, why does this end the turn? I'm just gonna check that really quickly. Why does salvo... Launching or throwing grenades or using heavy weapons with your first action will not end your turn. Oh. I always assumed that the minigun was a heavy weapon, but apparently it isn't. Oh, that is completely my bad. So that means if I use the acid bomb first and use that on the guys over here, does that hit the sector pod? It doesn't, does it? Yeah, it is marked as red, so I would think it would get hit by that. So I'm just gonna try and launch the acid bomb first. Because that would mean we get another action if I read it correctly. I should read those abilities a bit more. Yeah. We got the sector pod there as well. So that's good. That's good damage on both of those units. Which means I can now fire again. So let's fire at the Andromedon. 90% chance. 10 damage. That's really, really good. That almost takes it out. Who do we use next? So I'm assuming that the same applies to Ulrich. The annoying thing is, I could use something like saturation fire, but that of course is gonna kill the civilian. Even if I do Shredstorm, is probably the same, although it's a smaller cone. Might actually be able to aim this. Nah. I try to aim this past the civilian. Yeah, I get something like this. Okay then. Fair enough. Then I am going to use... Jesus. Not Jesus, but Jazz. But, I can't inspire at... Oh, wait. Can I actually save civilians with the Codex? That would be ridiculous, but... I'm assuming he can. Because technically that's one of our troop. I'm just gonna check that out. That is interesting. Oh no, he just runs away. Ah shit. That was a bit of a bad decision. So we have a shot at the elite trooper over there, or the Andromedon over here. A psionic bomb that disables the weapons of any units caught in its radius and deals damage within that radius after one turn. That is... well, that might be our saving grace. Of course, that's what the... yeah, that's what the Codex can do. So psionic bomb, there we go. So that disables... that should disable all the... oh, it only disabled one weapon, apparently. That might have been a waste. Although we'll probably never know. Okay, I'm gonna have to put Vinny a bit closer. Again, in this very bad position over here.
I can handle that.
Yes, you can, but... yeah, that's not the perfect position for him. And I don't have a lightning hands shot over here. Because I'm still one turn away from that. So, which means I'm gonna have to do something rather drastic. Well, the dangerous as well. I'm gonna put Jazz over here. So that takes two actions instead of one. It is annoying, but that saves the civilian over there, or activates it if it's a faceless. I can't talk anymore for some reason. Let's go over there. Okay, so that's good. So that frees our way to use the Shredstorm cannon. In our next turn, which is of course really, really good. But first, using heavy weapons is part of that skill. So if I go for this, if I move one to the right, can I get that? Nope, that gets Jazz as well. So I need to fire it like this, which is sad because I just missed those two guys over there. And I do hit, oh wait, I think like this, because otherwise I take out Jazz's cover as well. Hopefully I don't do that right now. It's also a bit of a waste of the Shredstorm cannon, so I might actually wait. Vinny, I'm gonna need him with fanfire in a minute, and then yeah, Hugh, you fire at the Andromedon. Please take it out. There we go. Okay. So that takes out the driver. The pilot, if you like. There we go. And now we should get the Shredstorm cannon in there. So just... yeah, I think this was what I wanted to do, right? So hit the sector bolt and hit the Andromedon. Right in the face. Boom! So that doesn't kill either of them, but it gets them pretty close. Next up, saturation fire. Pretty much the same deal, although I can't reach... I can't reach the sector pulse from here. So, scratch that. EMP bomb, how much damage does that do? It does 12. And that would kill the Andromedon, which is good. And that saves up... can I put that... oh, I can get it all the way over there as well if I want to. So let's wait with Ulrich's shot. If I... I think I can just take out... because face-off would be nice, but I can't reach anybody else. So just use fanfire on the Andromedon shell. Goodbye. It needed two shots, so that's... that's well spent, I believe. Oh, we still have way too many enemies left. They're gonna have to move, though. If they want to get out of that psionic storm, they're gonna have to move. And if they move... I'm gonna use the incendiary bomb. Because they're gonna have to move. And maybe I should... although I should take out the... sector bolt, but he has way too much health left. And the the incendiary bomb isn't gonna do me much good, so let's just go with the EMP bomb on the sector bolt, because otherwise I don't really have any other options. I still don't know why it gets further than the incendiary bomb. Might just be because the radius is that much larger. But yeah, incendiary bomb, incendiary bomb. EMP bomb, right over there. There we go. So that doesn't do anything to the shield bearer, of course. But I'm hoping that we get something else out of this. Because otherwise we might actually have just lost Jazz. Okay, here we go. Oh, he doesn't die. And he's not acid burning either. 3 damage, okay. Oh, and that's... Of course that's a faceless. Of course that's a faceless. Oh, shit. Oh, he's pretty close to Jazz. So he's leaving. And then the shield bearer is getting pretty close. Is he just gonna use shields? Yeah, okay, that's good. Because we can quickly take him out and get rid of the shields that way. Oh, shit, yeah. I'm sorry, Jazz. Please duck. Oh no, Blade Storm. Ah, but that doesn't kill him. That doesn't kill him. And Jesse's shot isn't close enough to... Does that stop him from attacking me? Oh no, it doesn't. Oh, that blocked. Oh, the armor blocked pretty much everything. He's gonna survive, even if the Sectopod tries to fire. Wait. Did the Sectopod just do nothing? Oh, and that's gonna explode. Goodbye. So that removes the shield of the Sectopod as well. I'm wondering why he stays there. I could just slash the faceless because he's right in front of my face. But I think I'm gonna start it off with Vinny. Because if I can get Vinny in a pretty good position, I think here should suffice.
I'm going.
There we go. We can use face off to hit two of them. That is that's gonna be a waste. I can use lightning hands to take out the shield bear because the EMP rounds go through his shield. Taking him out immediately. Goodbye.
Impressed yet?
So that removes the shield of the back trooper as well. And then we... Wait, that was a... Oh yeah, I moved him as well. And then we could use another pistol shot to try and take out the faceless. Which might not be such a bad idea. Ah, 5 damage. That's just 1 damage short of... killing it. Is that thing burning because of the slash? It is not. Could try and get Jazz in a better position to take out the Sectopod, although I want to use Jazz to just slash this guy to hell or just shoot this guy to hell. That might also be an option. What else can we do? There's not good cover for Yang. There's no good cover for Yang. So I'm just gonna... Why not? I'm just gonna use the Codex, which has pretty bad aim, by the way. And move him further. And just move him... I can actually teleport, right? Teleport to a new location. That would be ridiculous, but... Oh, I can let her or him or it take out the faceless. Blammo, goodbye. Okay. Yeah, because we're 7 strong at the moment. Could get Jazz a bit closer, but I should put him behind the car if I do that. There we go. Yang. Yang doesn't have any good cover, sadly. Because she can get a shot in at the Sectopod. Because she's not fully leveled yet, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, let's do that. Kill the Sectopod. Goodbye. And that's just gonna explode. Good riddance.
Right.
Oh, and it even dropped
this
loot. Ah, okay. I could use a slash to get in there, but then of course I risk leaving him out in the open. Jesse can just move up, and then Hugh Same problem, actually. No cover, because I removed pretty much everything around here. But we still have kind of an ace in the hole here. I think I could use saturation fire to get all the way over there. So I'm gonna put him out in the open and try and get saturation fire in over there. Should check the paw thing of that thing as well. Just gonna put it to the left a bit because I don't want to accidentally destroy the car. And that stops right before the civilians, which is good as well. So saturation fire. Oh, just not dead. Almost killed him. So Jazz is gonna have to mop that up. Jazz, are you ready to slash your way through this? No. Not that. Not the codex. Just slash this guy. I don't get a good position out of this as well, so might just shoot at it. 68, why? This is a freaking flank shot. He's not behind low cover. Okay then, never mind. Let's just get it over with. Goodbye. Was that the last enemy? Well, aside from the obvious, that. Faceless. I think if I'm not mistaken, Jazz has implacable. But otherwise it's untouchable, but promotion earned, that's really good. Apparently he doesn't have implacable, which might be a problem. Overwatch. Where is he going? He's pointing at someone. What? Why did you die? Oh, did you catch fire for some reason? One of the civilians just dropped dead for no reason. Okay, he can't reach me. That is really good. Well, he can reach me with a second toss, but we have this. Burning damage. And then he goes inside of the acid. Interesting choice. Very interesting choice. Yeah, you can be pissed all you want. So I think Jazz got a promotion. So the only one we really want to have a promotion on is, of course, our dear beloved Jesse. So let's just soul fire the hell out of this faceless and get it over with. A wooshy 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 wooshy! Blam! I do like the animation on that attack. That's just... Here, psionic energy in your face! And that's it.
1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear.
Oh yeah, that went pretty smoothly all in all. We did get wounded by the slash of that... that one faceless that got too close. So there we go, 100% successful shot percentage, probably. Yeah, we hit a few enemies with the same attack, so that's why. Vinny dealt most damage and made most attacks. The Mimic Beacon was under fire the most, and Jazz moved the furthest, of course. Because he has quite some reach at the moment. But we stopped the Advent Retaliation Strike, and therefore we're gonna get a few more supplies from this region. I think it was East Asia. And there we go. Back at the Avenger. Safe and sound. Well, aside from the minor damage on Jazz, but he shouldn't be out for more than a few days. There we go, lightly wounded. One day, and he got promoted. Which means, a rupture shot on Jazz. That is amazing. So a rupture shot deals critical damage and ensures that the target takes an additional +3 damage from all attacks in the future. So now we could go for rapid fire, but yeah, we've built him out as a blade master. So let's go with Reaper, a devastating chain melee attack. Where the first melee attack cannot miss. Each melee kill in Reaper mode grants an extra action, but further melee attacks have reduced damage. So yeah, could be handy to pick off a few low health enemies. So there we go, Reaper. And that's that. Jazz has a whopping 34 kills, by the way. Nothing compared to Vinny's 60 kills, but it's very impressive nonetheless. There we go, Illyrium Core, Superior Stock, Alien Data Cache, and a Superior Scope. So I'm actually able to get another trophy if I want to.
You still managed to exceed my expectations. Excellent work.
You're welcome. So I'm actually going to do that right now. We're going to get ourselves a trophy I haven't had yet. So let's view our soldiers. And I think... Ulrich, yeah, why not? Ulrich. Advanced expanded magazine and a stock. That is abysmal for you. So let's just go with superior hair trigger would be nice. Superior scope as well. But of course, we want to swap the advanced expanded magazine with the superior expanded magazine. There we go. And then we swap the stock with either a superior stock, which does guaranteed 3 damage. Which, yeah, why not, eh? His machine gun does a guaranteed 3 damage, which is really, really good. So, yeah, there we go. And that should give me a trophy Excalibur. So that's a trophy earned. That's a trophy you get for upgrading a beam weapon with 2 superior weapon upgrades. So there we go. Now that that's done, we're going to head towards the bridge, if I'm not mistaken. Because we're still researching a few things, if I'm not mistaken. Should check the log for that. Intel, that is interesting. I do need more intel, but in 2 days the Gatekeeper autopsy is complete. And I was thinking we were still making contact with the region. There we go.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
So Gatekeeper autopsy.
I have come to suspect that this creature's unusual appearance is somehow directly connected to its notable psionic aptitude. The aliens always have some reasoning to their actions, even as twisted as it is often revealed to be.
So, codename Barrett. Having encountered a number of aliens capable of wielding psionic power, it should come as no surprise that their aptitude and abilities are often unique to a given species. In this case, the subject henceforth referred to as the Gatekeeper is on the extreme end of the spectrum in terms of psionic sensitivity. However, our efforts to analyze the subject have so far revealed little in terms of its actual purpose or intention in the field. Unlike the Codex, so far we found nothing that would allow the Gatekeeper to open or control a rift. All current indications point to an unusual, independent, unpredictable species. So new item, Alien Psi Amp. This version of the psionic amplifier incorporates artifacts from the powerful Gatekeeper alien we've encountered. It will put our experienced Psi operatives on the same level as the alien's most powerful psionic forces. Which is of course really, really good. Then, we could get intel from this, so I'm gonna do that at the moment.
Valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
And then we'll head to engineering.
Just report and I'll get started, Commander.
And let's build that improved Psi Amp. So 1 Gatekeeper shell, 200 supplies, 10 alien alloys, and 15 Illyrium crystals. There we go. Easy as that. Now I do want to still check this out.
The least bit sorry to hear the elders are dying off. If anything, morale probably got a boost once word spread outside of the senior staff. Of course, there's always a catch. They've always got a scheme. And I get the impression we're going to end up part of their cure whether we like it or not.
Oh, we don't need the... Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm such an idiot. I don't need to upgrade the Shadow Chamber to do that. I am going to start doing that after we've gotten the intel out of the data pad. Because we need the intel faster at the moment. So let's continue making contact with New Chile. And stasis completely stuns the target for 1 turn, but renders them immune to any damage or attack. Continue the training, because we can keep giving her new abilities. And the Null Lance, of course, is amazing. So I think I'm just going to go for the Null Lance. Thank you very much. So let's get back to the bridge and continue scanning. There we go. Landing in New Chile. And that's another region unlocked for us. I'm doubting whether I should go for the intel that's on the map right now.
Long live the resistance.
If it's still there.
Regional contacts located.
And we can take out the alien facility there as well. What the spare parts do? All proving ground project costs reduced by 50%. Yeah. Not that interesting. So yeah, this makes it clear. We still have four regions we need to contact at the moment. But I think I'm going to go for the intel first. Where was it? Scorched Earth. There we go. We could use all the intel we can get. Although I do want to get a radio relay. We only need one. So if I can get it in Brazil, that would be peachy. So first, intel. And there gets the
I could have predicted this outcome.
61 intel.
Intriguing.
So let's carry on and head to the Shadow Chamber and start the Avatar research.
Commander, the lab is currently idle.
Yeah,
you're
I know.
Wasting valuable time and resources by
I know.
Not conducting any research.
Shh.
Please consider providing us with a directive.
This creature there we go.
Represents a near perfect fusion of human and elder DNA. Though remarkable, it appears as if the creature were unfinished. Perhaps why we were able to ultimately defeat it. Still, this can lead me to only one logical conclusion.
Oh shit. Hello, Elder. There goes one of the Elders.
I believe we have found our avatar.
Tum tum tum. But yeah, we still need to wait 5 more days until that is completed. So let's head back to the bridge. And there we go, new guerrilla operations activated. Let's review the targets. Scientists, we don't have any use for scientists anymore. I'm just gonna look at the reward. 222 supplies. With the easiest mission of the bunch, and we block alloy padding. Not alloy padding, alloy padding. And that's intel. Huh. That, of course, is the most interesting one. Archon, Lancer Trooper, Andromedon Codex, Gatekeeper, Sectoid, Elite Officer, Heavy Mech. 11 enemies. So yeah, I'm gonna go for New Indonesia, because we need that intel stat. There we go, I swapped the squad around a bit, because we're gonna go on Operation Dawn Claw, where we need to hack a workstation on a train again. So, I'm actually wondering if I need to take another specialist instead. I do want to keep the pistol shots, but we might actually be able to go without one of the grenadiers, because I still want to have our healer available. Although you know what, let's just go with and my colonel as well. So let's just take Benito for once again, because he's been out and about for a while now. So let's give him the skulljack back, and of course something fancy, maybe the plated vest? Wait, the skulljack and then plated vest or just one of the rounds? I'm just gonna protect him, man. I mean, we don't want to get him, let him get hurt. So there we go, that's the team we're gonna head into. Yessi, our Psy operative, Jazz the Ranger, and then Geralt and Yang are grenadiers, Vinny our sharpshooter, which of course is a gunslinger, and then Benito as our hacker. So before that, I'm gonna take a little break, so thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube, and if you haven't already, don't forget to give the thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate the support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!